Hi students, today we are going to discuss the second part of fourth module, that is notches and wears. So in notches and wears, you have to study different types of wears. So in your syllabus, wear is mostly discussed. There is not much difference between wear and notch that we can see. A notch and wear, both of them are constructed across a channel for measuring the discharge. So for measuring discharge, we are constructing a notch or wear perpendicular to the flow direction. So you can understand it clearly from this figure. That is, here a rectangular wear is shown. You can see a channel, and across the channel a rectangular wear is constructed. Normally wear is constructed by using concrete structures, and notch is constructed using steel structures. So using steel structures, notches can be constructed. So it is simply we can say it's a small structure, but wear is somehow a big structure. So for large purposes we are using wear. Okay, so based on the shape we can classify wear into different heads, that is rectangular wear and triangular wear, trapezoidal wear, etc. So in this figure you can see a rectangular wear over which the water or fluid flows. This type of structures can be constructed for measuring the discharge. So these are the dimensions of the rectangular wear. This is the length of the wear. So this is a different view of the wear. So we can see in detail. So there are two terms that you have to understand before going to discuss the details of wear. There is one is nappe or wave. There is a sheet of water flowing through a notch or over a wear is called nappe or wave. So in this figure you can see this is the sheet of water flowing over the wear. So this is called the nappe or wave. Okay. So other one is crest or sill. The bottom edge of a notch or a top of a wear over which the water flows is known as the sill or crest. Okay, that is the bottom edge of a notch or a top of a wear over which the water flows. So in this figure, the top edge of the wear, okay, top edge of the wear, it is clear from this figure, top edge of the wear is called a sill or crest of the wear. Okay, so notch is also a similar structure, but it's of small size. Notch is of small size, and that too built by using steel. Okay, wear is built by masonry or concrete structures. That is the main difference between wear and notch. The purpose is same, for measuring the discharge in a channel flow. Okay. So there are classification of wears based on the shape. So rectangular notch, triangular notch, trapezoidal notch, stepped notch, etc. So as you can see from here, this is a V-shaped wear. Okay. This is the original example for a wear that is constructed using concrete across or perpendicular to the direction of the flow. It is clear or evident from this figure. Okay, this is of shape V. So this can be said as V-shaped wear. So based on this shape, it can be a trapezoidal or rectangular, etc. So here it is a rectangular wear because the shape is a rectangular wear. So this is the length of the wear. Length of the wear means the length measured in this bottom side, since it is a rectangular shape. So this is the depth of the wear. Okay. So second classification is according to the effect of the sides on the nappe. Notch with end contraction and notch without end contraction, or suppressed notch, etc. So you can just see the different types according to the shape: rectangular, trapezoidal, triangular wear. So this is the classification of notch, and this is the classification of wear. Somehow it is similar, but there are slight differences. Okay. According to shape of the crest, there are four types of wears. So this we will discuss, that is sharp crested wear, broad crested wear, and narrow crested wear and ogee shaped wear. Okay, so we can see one by one in detail, so that time you can understand clearly. So just now you have to just understand the names of these different types of wares and to what heads they are classified. Okay, so rectangular wear, triangular wear, trapezoidal wear, sharp crested wear, broad crested wear, narrow crested wear, ogee shaped wear. And also effect, based on the effect of sides, there is another classification, like in notch, wear with end contraction and wear without end contraction. Okay, so first we have to discuss the discharge over a rectangular notch or wear. Okay, as the name indicates, the shape of the wear is rectangular. Okay, so you have to remember that wear is a structure constructed perpendicular to the flow direction in the channel. So this is a nappe or vein of the channel, vein of the wear. Okay, so this is the crest or sill of the wear, top edge of the wear. Nappe means a sheet of water flowing across the wear. Okay, so there is a differences. So this is a rectangular type of wear. We are going to discuss that rectangular type of wear and how to measure the discharge, equation for discharge in rectangular notch or wear. The equation can be applied for both notch and wear since it is of similar shape but different size and used of different materials. Notch is made by steel and wear is made by concrete structures or masonry structures. So that is the difference, but the equation for discharge is the same. Okay, so we can discuss this rectangular notch or wear in detail.